Children, I welcome you all in today's class on the topic weather and climate. As this happens to be our second class, let's first recall what we have discussed earlier. Yes, we discussed about how weather and climate are different from each other. Children, by now we are aware of what weather and climate is. Weather. It reflects short-term condition of temperature, whereas climate reflects long-term condition of temperature. Weather changes quickly. It fluctuates. Whereas climate remains same over a long period of time in a specific area. Now children, our today's topic will be factors affecting climate. Children, climate depends largely on the relief features of land. There are certain factors that affect the climate of a place. These factors are distance from an equator, altitude, distance from the sea, direction of winds, humidity, and ocean currents. Children, first we'll talk about distance from equator. Equator is a 0 degree latitude. I have explained to you in the earlier class also. Children, if you look at this diagram here on page number 19, children, at the equator is here. At the equator, the rays are direct and vertical. Therefore, the areas near to the equator will receive intense and direct heat. But towards the poles, rays are slanting and spread over a large area. That is why the areas near the poles are cold. Now, next is altitude. Children, you need to remember one concept of altitude, that is, the higher above the sea level you go, the colder it gets. This is because the higher you go, the thinner the air is. Therefore, there is less air to trap the heat and the air is colder. Children, hill stations have cold climate due to the height above the sea level, which is called altitude. That is, an elevation is called altitude. The temperature decreases with increase in height. This is very important. As you go up, the temperature comes down. The higher we climb, the cooler the air is. Now children, let's talk about distance from the sea. Children, while we discuss about the distance from the sea, we will be talking about two concepts. One, that is the sea breeze, and two, that is the land breeze. Now I'll show you here with a diagram, and this diagram you will be drawing in your copy also, beta. All right. Now children, the places near to the sea are neither too hot nor cold. Now, they have equable climate. Equable climate means neither too hot nor too cold. And this happens because of the land and sea breeze effect near the coastal areas. Now children, actually what happens? See, this is the diagram of sea breeze. And here what happens, it takes place during the daytime. The sun heats both land and water, but land absorbs more heat than water. Therefore, the warm air above the land rises and the cool air from the sea takes its place. It rises above and this cool air moves from the sea to the towards the land, and this phenomena is known as sea breeze. Okay, so it balances the temperature. Now next phenomena is the land breeze. Children, land breeze takes place during night. The land cools down more quickly than sea. This is the property of land. The air above the sea is warmer and rises up, because we know that the warm air rises up. The cool air from the land takes its place. This is called land breeze. So the weather is neither very hot nor very cold near to the places located at the coastal areas. Now children, now we'll be talking about direction of winds. Children, direction of winds, very important. It is very important. It means from where and which direction they are actually coming. That is very important and it affects the climate of a place. Now winds coming from the hot areas increases the temperature, and the winds which are coming from the cold regions will lower the temperature of a place. The winds may also bring moisture, and these are known as rain bearing winds. In India, the winds coming from the Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal bring rain to the entire country. Children, next factor is humidity. Children, humidity basically is the amount of moisture in the air. The winds blowing over the sea brings lots of moisture and makes the climate of the coastal areas very humid. So that is why when we go to the coastal area, we feel so sticky. Our skin feels so sticky because there is moisture in the air, because it is near to the coastal areas. So that is why the climate of the coastal areas is very humid. Now last we have is the ocean currents, children. These ocean currents can be cold as well as warm. These are the flow of water below the surface of the ocean. They affect the climate of a place, as these currents may be cold and warm, as I have told you earlier also, children. So these are some of the factors which affects the climate of a particular place. Now children, that's all for today. You revise till page number 20, factors affecting the climate, and then in the next class we'll be talking about the types of climate. That's all for today. Bye, have a good day.